you want to engage in a snail farming, you should not only focus on what the breeding aspect, but you should try as much as possible to tap into some other activities in the value chain, like the processing, like the marketing, like transporting it to the customer, leasing with some distributor agent so that they can buy or produce and sell to them. The consultation aspects of it, marketing other people's product, or doing the buying and reselling. With all these activities in the snail value chain, you should be able to get some return on investment within the stipulated time. But if you focus on only breeding, that is when you see that it takes time, like 1 year, 1 year and a half, 2 years maximum, to get return on your investment. That is why people get discouraged along the way. And the snail farming requires a lot of patience. If you don't have the patience, you cannot go into it. But if you combine those factors, like I said earlier, sometimes when you go in the buying the resales, if you invest 2,000, you get 4,200 back within the time the stock has to leave you. So that's a good, and I've not seen any sector or any produce that will even give you 120% return on investment. I've not seen one yet. So now we are at the income projections for the snail farm. Mostly everybody's attention is about the income, forgetting the processes that have to go through to what successfully breed, manage, successfully process, market their snails. They have forgotten those things, but the focus is on the money. And these are some of the activities that lure the people into the sector if they are facing challenges and get back. And some of these figures on the internet, people over exaggerate about the figures when it comes to the income projections, which actually not true.